Before anyone here gets freaked out, starts thinking, who invited this guy to our town? Let me make something really clear. I am an illusionist. That means that what you just experienced was just an illusion. Yeah, you guys are smart. Obviously, I don't have any sort of psychic powers or magical abilities or Harry Potter skills or anything like that. That was just a trick. A trick on your eyes, a trick on your mind, and nothing more. In fact, guys, that is a simple trick that I can explain to everyone here tonight in about 5 minutes or less. I won't. But I could. Here's why. Think of all this stuff I'm doing up here tonight, the art of magic, the art of illusion, just like any other learned art form in the world. It's a natural ability, but it takes hours of practice. Just owning a piano or a guitar doesn't make someone a musician any more than knowing the secret to a trick makes someone an illusionist. It's that where the hours of practice come, invested into it, to be able to perform it, make it seem so believable. But it's possible to create something with the right knowledge and practice that looks real, that is totally fake. And that was an interesting idea to me. A little over 10 years ago, I was fascinated by this because of an experience I had in Southeast Asia. I was on a tour in India and Sri Lanka, which is this little island off the southern coast of India. In the country of Sri Lanka, I performed an illusion with an old antique table, very similar to this one that my little sister Haley is bringing out on stage behind me. After the show, this man came up to me. He was very fascinated by this table. True story. He keeps asking me questions like, hey, where'd you get that table? Come to find out, he's asking because according to him, down the street from where he lived, in his village, there was another man who had a table, and apparently his table looked exactly like mine. He just assumed it maybe it was the same table. He's like, hey, where'd you get that table? The guy has a table. So apparently the man who had the table claimed that it can move around, but it can move around by itself without anyone touching it, that it could just slide across the floor without anyone touching it because of spirits, that the spirits were manifesting their presence by possessing the table and making it move. I was a little skeptical. I wasn't sure what to believe, to be honest with you. So I decided I should go visit this man with this mysterious table and do a little bit of research. What I discovered shocked me, taught me a lesson I will never forget. Before I tell you what that was, I want to perform this for you. To do this, I need some more help from the audience. If you'd like to come up on stage, please raise your hand. All right, let's go. Good. Were you so excited that you fell out of your chair? Did someone push you out of your chair? You got pushed out of your chair. Yeah, all right, cool. I'm sorry they did that to you. They should really treat you better than that, right? They're your friends. All right, come on over here and stand on this side. Tell me your name.
Kenna.
All right. I was like, Kenna Jackson. That's a cool name, but that's like your last name combined into one word. So that's how you talk in Alabama, right? Yeah, cool. I'm just messing with you. I'm from Tennessee, so I know how that works. All right. I'm going to ask you to help me out with this table. It's really simple. There's a tablecloth right across the top. Step just a tiny bit closer to the table. Not too close. Back just a little bit. Right over that trap door. Alright, I just want you to be able to reach the tablecloth. Grab one corner each hand. You can step a little bit closer. I'm going to hold two corners over here on mine. Now, sometimes this works, sometimes it doesn't. If this does work, do not hold the table down. Don't put any downward pressure on it. Just hold the corners while it's going to be flat. If it works, if the table decides to move, I just need you to move with the table. Okay?